Hey guys, Chris from Harmony Turbines here. I'm coming at you from our little manual milling machine area where we use these machines for doing testing on our new generators and the cores that we wind, the different platters of magnets that we're testing, different configurations really. And one of the biggest things that we've been dealing with lately is epoxies. We've probably tried 6 different types of epoxies, maybe 5 different types of epoxies, and we have a new one on order that is very promising. What we're looking for with our epoxies is several really important things. One, we don't want that epoxy to droop over time. So we need it to be really, when it cures, we need it to be like glass or ceramic. We need it to hold its shape for indefinitely. And that's a super important feature. We also need it to be able to remove heat from the coils. So it needs to have high heat conductivity, but at the same time, little to no electrical conductivity. So, you know, you have all these things that we need. Now they have potting epoxies that are out there, and we have moved to getting those and starting to test those. But initially we were doing some epoxies that were clear, and we never intended to go into production with the clear epoxies, but it allowed us to do some rapid testing. The newer ones, we actually bought an oven over here. We're going to be baking our new cores in that oven. And that helps to cure the epoxy in probably about a 4-hour time frame. And so we don't have to let it sit for 2, 3, 4 days like we did in previous videos before it's hard. So even though these may seem like they're hard and rigid, they may still droop over time. So we're gonna have to do things like droop tests and things like that. Maybe we'll make another video down the road as we begin testing other epoxies. So one of the things that we want to look at as we are considering our epoxies is the machinability. We have to be able to get a perfectly smooth lower surface and an upper surface. And up to this point, we've been using open face molds that we've been pouring, and then we would machine the top surface. But when you machine the top surface, you run the risk of nicking wires. And that was always something we were working on. How do we come up with a way to do this without possibly nicking our wires or causing a problem there? And we've come up with a way that, obviously this is an entire core, but when we do the smaller ones, we've started doing some testing. Now this one we were also doing machining on, and you can see we had a small nick there. You don't want to have any chance of nicking or hurting your wires as you're doing it. There's another nick there, another nick there. The little shiny areas, that's what we don't want. You don't want to see these little nicks where you have the possibility of causing a short. So we'd like to get away from that completely. And to have a completely smooth upper and lower surface is the goal. But to do that, we've now started using a lid on our open face mold after we do the pour to give us a completely smooth flat surface. And having a few bubbles or voids in it hurts nothing. We, in the end, have a perfectly smooth surface so that when we have it in our generator, now the generator is able to have a very, very precise upper air gap and a lower air gap when the magnets spin. So this process, if I could keep it in neutral, this process allows us to test that. I'm not screwed in here to hold it, but there we go. If I'm holding it really rigid, it's not bumping at all because we're keeping a very, very tight air gap above and below those cores. So the epoxy, even though it seems like a no-brainer, like, oh, just get some epoxy and put your coils in it and you're good to go, it's not. There's a lot that goes into it. There's a lot of properties we need to be able to maintain. Then there's a lot of finished applications that we need to be able to do to this to make sure that we get the end result we need. In the end, I think we've now settled on the exact process that we need to get a perfectly smooth upper and lower surface, control the height of it, and have everything dialed in exactly like we want, which is super exciting, guys. Because when you're working through this stuff and you're like, okay, we've got to machine it, but now we have these problems introduced, you know, you have to solve these problems. And that's what we're good at. We're good at sitting there, and after a little bit of trial and error, we say, wow, all we have to do is this, and we have a perfect process to now get absolutely perfectly flat upper and lower surfaces on our coils without any issues nicking or hitting wires or anything like that. And that's really, really cool when you think about it, guys. There's a lot of processes that companies will go through that maybe they didn't really think it through, they didn't test it enough. We're trying to balance just the right amount of testing, the right amount of proof of concept to make sure that we hit all of the big gotchas, the big problems that could occur, but we're not wasting time going down rabbit holes trying to find that 1% or 2% gain or make this process just 5 minutes faster or whatever. We're looking for the big gains that are going to, in the end, all come together to make a cohesive product that's amazing for you, the end user. And that's our goal here at Harmony Turbines. So the progression is pretty cool. You know, when you think about it, in the end, everything we're learning on the small scale, the small, quick, rapid prototyping allows us to see how we can do it better in the full scale. And doing this saves time, it saves money, it saves wire, it saves everything. So we're able to see very quickly and rapidly how these perform, not only the coils themselves and the magnet arrays, but the epoxy itself, everything holding it together. And that's awesome when you think about it. So just wanted to share that update with you guys, let you know where we're at, share some of the thought process that goes on behind the scenes, help you understand why this stuff does take some time. It's not something we can do overnight because we have to make sure we get these problems. Well, we find these problems and then we solve these problems. So we're in that constant balance where we're trying to get the best bang for the buck for you, our consumers, our investors, our future customers. We're getting that low-hanging fruit to make sure that we have an amazing product for you in the end. So thank you, Chris from Harmony Turbines. Take care until next time. See ya.
Harmony Turbines. We now have the power to change the world.